And I'm not saying in some, you know, I'm not saying that a man and a woman can't be friends, if that makes sense. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is, yeah, in some cases that happens. A man and a woman can be friends, right? And I think, you know, this also factors, you know, there's factors in how a man and a woman become friends, right? It could be, you know, through a work-life relationship, you know, they work together. For the most part, they have some things in common. They get along with each other for the most part. Let's say it like that. But there's, of course, we know there's no kind of attraction. There's no physical attraction. But it's more like, you know, the woman or the man like her personality enough to where she's cool to, you know, hang out with or work with. Or, you know, just, you know, either hang out or work with. We'll stick with that. But I like to think in some cases also a man and a woman can be friends, but I think it depends on if the woman is not attracted to the man like that, or the man is not attracted to the woman like that. And then there is where the friend zone takes place, right? Right. And I also know that women are the ones who utilize this tactic more, right? But I like to think men also utilize it too. It's just that it's not, you know, it's not, what's that word I'm looking for? It's not globalized. It's not, you know, frowned upon, if that makes sense. It's not like, oh my gosh, when a man does it, oh, he's mean, how could he do this? Why do men do this? Why do men friend zone women? No, it's more like frowned upon when a woman does it, right? Even though it shouldn't be frowned on when a woman does it either, because it's all right. If a woman is not attracted to the man, why in the world should she, you know, lie to him or make him think that it's going to be something more than it's not? And again, yeah, so women put a guy in the friend zone because of, you know, the attraction's out there. But some women also put a guy in the friend zone when he fumbles the ball, if that makes sense. It could be, you know, yeah, the attraction was initially there, but the guy did something when they, you know, met, you know, at, let's say, a public coffee shop or something. And during that first date, that first encounter, you know, that first time, the very first time they spent time together, it's something he did, or it's just something that you know, she just wasn't feeling like she was feeling initially when they, you know, when they met online, or they met in a store, a club, wherever, right? And yeah, again, she just, you know, for whatever reason, she's turned off now. So now she has placed him in a friend zone. The same can go for the man. Initially, he was attracted to the woman, and now, bam, you know, from again, whatever, online, the club, a store, wherever they met, right? And yeah, the attraction was there initially, right? And then now when they met and actually sat down and spent some time together, he got, you know, something she did that turned him off, or something she said that turned him off. So now she's in the friend zone. So again, for me, I think what's getting lost, and I think where a lot of people get things confused when it comes to a man or woman and whether they can be friends or not, I think where the confusion comes from, because in reality, yeah, this is how it's actually supposed to be, if that makes sense. It's supposed to be, if a woman is, you know, feeling the guy like that, she's attracted to the guy like that, and, you know, the man is mutual, right? It's mutual between, you know, for the man, or vice versa, mutual for the woman. Then, okay, yeah, why would they not want to start a relationship, right?
But again, if it's not mutual on whoever's part, then okay, why not? Why we can't just be friends and talk or hang out here and there? We don't have to be romantically involved. We don't have to have sex. Why don't we just hang out and talk sometimes? Why don't we go meet somewhere? Why don't we just do some things together or something? Outside of, you know, you coming into my apartment or I come into your apartment. Or in some cases, yeah, you can come over as long as you know that nothing's going to happen sexually, right? Okay, we get that. So, again, this is how it's actually supposed to go. This is how it's supposed to actually work. But unfortunately, who likes rejection more than anything, right? Or should I say, one of the biggest reasons, in my opinion, why people do these things, you know, when it comes to, oh, should I just friendzone this guy, or should I friendzone this woman, or, okay, yeah, I'm attracted to her, oh, yeah, great, she's attracted to me, or I'm attracted to him, oh, great, he's attracted to me, so now we can try to start a relationship, right? Yeah, I think what's happening is where, you know, I think this is why people play games like that regardless, because who likes rejection? Nobody likes rejection. I don't care what nobody says. You can sit up all day long and keep saying things like, oh, I don't care if I get rejected. I'm immune to rejection. No, my feelings don't get hurt. You can't hurt my feelings. Yeah, if you reject me, okay, yeah, fine. There's somebody out there that's gonna want me, right? That's the old traditional saying. There's somebody out there there's somebody out there for everybody, right? Okay. But again, who likes rejection? Who likes it? So think about it. Rejection hurts. And I think it hurts everybody. When someone rejects you, and especially if you really like this person, like, you are attracted to this person, right? But all of a sudden, it's not reciprocated. So now you're like, oh, wow. Damn, I feel like a loser, right? You feel like the worst person in the world. You feel like nobody wants you. You get one of those moves where nobody wants you. Oh, wow, I must be ugly or something. Oh, man. Was my breath smelling bad? Did I forget to put deodorant on? Was my cologne? Was it not the right cologne? Was it the way I dressed? Was it my outfit? Was it not, you know, appropriate, if that makes sense? Was it not politically correct, if that makes sense? Was it my hair? Did I cut it? Was it cut in a way that it just wasn't appealing to her? Was it my teeth or something? Did I forget was my teeth stained or something? You just go into all these reasons why this person rejects you. When in reality, the person rejects you because you're just not their type. That's why you got rejected. But some people can't handle that, right? So they try to, you know, go into denial. Some, you know, yeah, they actually don't want to take no for an answer. So some, you know, you got some people who press the envelope a little. You even got some who will cross that line, you know, with the stalking, the harassing phone calls, or just being belligerent, having a belligerent-like attitude because the person, you know, rejected you. So now you want to jump on this person. You want to cuss this person out and so forth, because you got rejected. But yeah, I like to think in most cases, don't nobody like rejection, but some people can handle it, right? But I think this is why the games get played as far as in, you know, the friend zone tactic, when it's utilized by either the man or the woman. And I think another thing that plays a part in this is the fact that nobody likes hurting anybody's feelings. I like to think most people have compassion, if that makes sense. So, no, you don't want to hurt anybody's feelings, right? Because some people are just good people like that. They were raised right. They were raised to be respectful of all people, no matter what color they are, if that makes sense. You got, you know, they went to good schools and so forth, came up in, you know, decent environments or some, you know, good environment. No environment is perfect. So let's not even go there. But you had someone who had a decent upbringing and came up in a decent environment. So I'm going to say it like that. So, yeah, they were raised right. So you got most people who were raised right who don't want to hurt anybody's feelings. So, I mean, me personally, if I was asked the question, can a man or woman be friends? Yeah, they can. It just really depends on the situation. I don't think if you ask me straight up, can a man or woman be friends? I don't think a man or woman can actually be friends, if that makes sense. But it just depends on the situation because there's so many factors that's involved when it comes to a man or woman actually agreeing to just be friends, if that makes sense. There's a lot of factors that play into that, in my opinion, when that decision is made. So it just, again, it just depends on the man or woman. And, you know, if they're both, if either they're looking for the same thing or they, you know, it's just the attraction is not there for either one of them. Or in some cases, both don't have that attraction. But yeah, they rather be friends. They're cool. You cool to hang out with. You funny. I just don't have that. I'm not attracted to you romantically, but I wouldn't mind calling you up or, you know, we text or whatever. And, or yeah, if you want to go catch a game together or something like that, yeah, that's cool. Or in my case, I'm a DJ. If you want to come watch me DJ sometime, that's cool. Or you want to be a guest on my podcast because I have a podcast platform also. Yeah, you can come and be a guest on my podcast. You know, want to help out with my podcast. Yeah, if you want to, you know, just be a part of it, period. You want to be a part of either my DJ business or my podcast. Yeah, I wouldn't mind doing that with a woman that I just want to be friends with, if that makes sense. So I like to think, you know, some women feel the same way. Yeah, we're not, you know, I'm not attracted to you romantically, but yeah, you cool. You cool to hang out with. You cool to talk to. I wouldn't mind, you know, keeping you in my life as a friend. Yeah, some women, I believe they, you know, it just depends on the situation.